It means your father's side.
Yeah, but we don't call that the uncle though.
Yeah, but I agree. It's okay. I understand that. But you, if I say Baba Tugunde, you will understand that I'm talking about my father, brother. You understand that, right? If I say Baba Tugunde, you will understand my father, brother, right?
Yes.
What's the other one?
Cow.
Cow. Cow. Cow is... When you say cow, you will understand that it's on my mother's side. That's all I was asking. That's all. Hassan, that's all I was asking. So he mentioned Al-Miswar. He mentioned to his uncle Abi Jahl, he mentioned Hal Kuntum, that were you accusing of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam of any lie qabla an yaqula maqalatuhu allati qalaha. Allahu Akbar, very good point. He say, were you accusing the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam of any lie before he said what he said? Before he stood up and say, oh you my people, qulu la ilaha illallah, have you ever accused him of any lie before, prior to that? Have you ever accused him of any lie prior to that? Right? Before he said what he said. قَبْلَ أَنْ يَقُولَ مَقَالَتُهُ الَّتِي قَالَهَا. Before he said what he said. Did you ever accuse him of any lies? قَالَ أَبُو جَهْلِ لَعْنَةُ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى. Abu Jahl, may Allah, may the curse of Allah be on him. He say, Yabna Akhi, O you, the son of my brother. O you, the son of my brother. Laqad kana Muhammadun fina. Indeed, we raise Muhammad. Indeed, we raise Muhammad. Wa huwa shabun. And he was a young man. Yud'a, and he was being called Al-Amin, the trustworthy one. This is the statement of who? Abu Jahl. Abu Jahl, this was his statement. He say, لَقَدْ كَانَ مُحَمَّدٌ فِينَا. We raise Muhammad. Right? We raise Muhammad. وَهُوَ شَابٌ. And he was a young man. Yud'a al-Amin. And we used to call him al-Amin. Ma jarabna alayhi kathiban. Qat. We never, ever accuse him of any lie whatsoever. Never we had accused him of any lie. Qat. Never. Akhi, think about this. You were a child, right? You were raised, I'm not talking about in a house, but in a whole city of Mecca, right? And there was not one incident that you were called, you lied. Not one incident that nobody would say you lied. Or I think he's lying. Not even one time. Now look at the strong words of Abu Jahl. Ma jarabna. Ma jarabna alayhi kathiban of any lie. But never, ever have we accused him of any lie whatsoever. And when وَخَطَ الشَّيْبُ لَمْ يَكُنْ لِيَكْذِبَ عَلَى اللَّهِ. So when a shayb, when the gray hair comes, right? Then how would he lie on Allah? Is that possible? He was young, right? No one ever accused him of lying whatsoever. Now this was in regard to the people. In regard to the people. Then how in the world, when he grew up, that how in the world you want to accuse him of lying against Allah? Qal. Ya Khal. Who's speaking? La. Miswar. He say, oh, you my uncle. Falima. Why is it not? La tattabi'unahu. Why isn't it not that you don't follow him? The man, he was young, he never lied. You never accuse him of lying. He grew up. How would he lie upon his creator, upon Allah? How can he lie upon Allah? Then my uncle, why is it not that you follow him? Qala yabna akhi. Oh, you, the son of my brother. He is continuing to give it to him. Why didn't they believe? He say, Tanaza'na nahnu wa banu Hashim. He say, we were competing. Now this is Abu Jahl saying. They were all Arabs. Alhamdulillah. That's the same word. Tanaza'na, meaning we had, here you will not say dispute, but you will say competition. Yeah, right? You will say competition, and you will see when, you know, the explanation come, right? But a tanazo is dispute. When you have dispute or you have an argument, right? You say this, I say this. That's why he said in the Quran, فَإِن تَنَازَعْتُمْ fi shay'in. If you have a differences in anything, فَرُدُّهُ إِلَى اللَّهِ. They return it back to Allah and to the Messenger عليه الصلاة والسلام. Now Al-Miswara, he asked his uncle, then why is it not you did not follow the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, if you knew that he was telling the truth? Now Abu Jahl, he said to his nephew, he told him, يَبْنَ أَخِي, oh you the son of my brother. He said, تَنَازَعْنَا نَحْنُ وَبَنُوا هَاشِمْ. We had a competition with the Banu Hashim. We had a competition with the Banu Hashim. And the competition is still remaining upon this ummah. We're still competing in things. But are we competing in the right things? This is a big question mark. Are we competing in the proper things? Right? Are we competing in the proper things? And alhamdulillah, certain things, it is not to be competed about, let alone, it is not to be witnessed, let alone to compete about it. Because you are not aiding the next one coming. Hasan, it will be clear, inshallah. Just take it bits and bits. You understand? Meaning certain things that is not to be compete about. If you competing it, if you partaking on it, you're not helping the next one come in. Because they will not have no choice but to do that if they are weak hearted. Right? So Abu Jahl, and Timbo, he got it right, mashallah. He got the answer right, his homework. So Abu Jahl, he said to his nephew, "O you the son of my brother, we were competed with Banu Hashim. We were competing with them. Tayyip. What were we competing? Ash-sharafa, nobility. Who has more nobility? Who has more nobility? This is what we were competing. Who has more nobility? فَأَطْعَمُوا وَأَطْعَمْنَا. They were feeding the people, Banu Hashim, and we were feeding the people. So we were what? Competing. Is this a good competition? Yes, it is. Right? Because Allah says, "Sabiqu ila maghfiratin min rabbik." Compete in the mercy of your Lord. Right? And also in another verse in Surah Al-Waqi'ah, "Was-sabiquna as-sabiqun, ulaika al-muqarrabun." Those who win the race in the competition, they are the muqarrabun, they are the closest one to Allah. So it is a competition. But what to compete? What to compete? It is not who scored more goals in the World Cup. That's not the competition. Right? So, فَأَطْعَمُوا وَأَطْعَمْنَا. They fed people and we fed people. وَسَقَوْا وَسَقَيْنَا. They were quenching the thirst of the people. And likewise, we were trying hard to give people to drink. Because remember, when the people that used to come for the Hajj in Mecca, right? This was an act of worship that the Quraysh used to do. Feeding the people, quenching their thirst, because without a doubt, water in the desert, it is like a Cadillac in the city. Right? Water in the desert. You know what I mean? It's something that is very precious. Right? So those hujjaj come in to the pilgrimage, of course, you come in a city, a long route, and you're going to be running out of provision. Right? That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us what? That going to Hajj, you must take what? Provision, fatazawwadu, but the best provision is at taqwa. Fatazawwadu fa inna khayr azad at taqwa. So, wa ajaru wa ajarna. They exiled, meaning they gave asylum. We gave asylum. Right? They gave asylum, we gave asylum. So therefore, فَلَمَّا تَجَاثَيْنَا عَلَىٰ الرُّكْبِ وَكُنَّا. He say, when we reached that point, when we reach the point